Tonight we're preparing two fall dishes, and one we'll eat tonight, and the other one we're going to eat tomorrow night. So while I'm cooking, we might as well take care of two fall dishes. So let's get to it. When I think of fall, I think of apples. And we're going to cook an apple with an acorn squash. Gonna put that together in a little honey, a little butter, make a delicious sauce, and we're gonna serve that with some pork chops. Now, if you're not a pork chop person, that's fine. You can do the same thing with chicken, the other white meat. So let's get that fall dinner together. It's going to involve apples. And we're using some little Granny Smith apples. And they're pretty small. Let me get one. I had a bag of little Granny Smith apples. And they are just cute as they can be. Just enough for a snack or however your kids might like them. But I like to buy these because they're just enough, and they have great flavor. Now, I've rinsed my apples, and I'm gonna turn you down so you can see on the cutting board, but I've taken the time to peel them and slice them. And I have some butter that's softening that we're gonna be using with these, as well as a little bit of lemon, because we need that to keep them from changing colors so fast. And we're gonna need some brown sugar. Take a look at this acorn squash. I think I'm gonna need a larger knife to be able to do this. I don't fix these very often, and they're not the easiest thing to cut. So please be careful should you decide to purchase one with your finger. And once you get it open, you're gonna see that this little baby is full of seeds. In fact, it smells like a pumpkin. So I'm going to get a spoon, and we're going to scoop all of this out. And my plan is to bake these. And this is going to be our vegetable for tonight. I thought we'd cook them all together, but I think I'm just going to fix those pork chops by themselves and add this to the side, because I think it's going to be so pretty. Let me get something a little sharper. It can be a little stringy, so be prepared. I'll scoop some of this out. Just like you scoop out your pumpkin for Halloween, we're scooping out this acorn squash. So there's squash one, that's for the big guy. And of course, if you were going to have several other vegetables with this, then you wouldn't really even worry about the size. You could actually cut it down. But this is gonna be our main vegetable. I'm taking my spoon and I'm scraping around the inside to get most of the pulp out. Now you could actually just do one and then slice them in half. You could fill this with dressing. Ooh, that might be good. If you wanted to do it for a holiday affair and wanted it to look unusual, or if you were having just a dinner for two, that would be so pretty. So I've gotten these pretty clean. Takes a little muscle, just a little time. You can see I'm doing this real time, so you can see. All right, so our acorn squash is ready. And I'm gonna clean up and get all of that taken care of. I'm dropping you down where you can see a little better, but we're going to take these two acorn squashes and I'm gonna place them in this container. As you can see, let me see if I can get you a little better view. Make sure you can see everything, because I want you to do this. Now, what we're gonna do is that I'm gonna take a little salt. You know, we have to add a little salt to bring out the sweetness. And we did these in slices, but since we're gonna do it the way that we are inside of the acorn squash, I think I'm gonna cut them up just a little more. Give them a little more of a dice. Now I may not cut all of them. Let's see how many it's gonna take to fill these. Now you can use honey, you can use maple syrup, and I'm gonna place those in there. Okay, I think we have enough apples. I may chop just a little bit more. You know, you aren't quite sure how many you're going to need to do this, since we're doing something new. All right, there we go. There's one, apple one. You really want it to puff up a little bit. You know, it's like an apple pie. You don't want to put just enough apples to cover the bottom. You want just a tad bit extra. Okay, so I'm putting all those little pieces in. There we go. And you know what? I'm gonna add just a tad bit more salt to that. Now, it's time. We're gonna mix the butter, some apple pie spice, and a little extra cinnamon together. So let's do that. Now I have my bowl. I'm gonna add in about 2 tablespoons of butter. 2 tablespoons. So that's gonna be about half of this. One for each one. It's gonna be enough. I'm just gonna sit that there because I'll need that later. Don't worry about these apples. They are delicious. So I'm going to put in about 1 teaspoon of apple pie spice. I'm going to mix that up. See if I can find some extra cinnamon. Okay, I've got my cinnamon. I'm going to shake just a little bit more cinnamon in. You could even melt this if you want it. I'm trying not to have to warm up anything at this point until time for dinner, to get ready for dinner, because we're working on this early. Okay, there's our mixture. We need some brown sugar. So let's get a little brown sugar. I've got it right here. And let me get a longer spoon. So I've got a tablespoon. That's 2 tablespoons. And I'm putting in our mixture. Now this is salted butter, so I don't need to add any salt to this. But you know, under normal circumstances, you would want to put in just a touch of salt to bring out the flavors. Now, this is where I'm going to add a little bit of maple syrup. Spoon. Okay, we're just kind of estimating. Okay, we've got our maple syrup in there. Oh yeah, that's gonna be good. And you know, if you have a little rum, you could throw some rum in. Ooh, what was that? Something fell. All right, now I'm gonna divide this into half. So there's one right there. And this is going to melt into this acorn squash. And that's 2. My hands are clean, guys. Then I have this for a little while. Make sure you get everything. Okay. While these pork chops are grilling on top of the stove, I have the acorn squash in the oven. It took about 42 minutes to an hour for them to be nice and soft and golden on top. Now, because we're using brown sugar and because we've got lots of butter, it's going to be a little crusty, and the top may get just a little bit browner than you want, so keep an eye on it. And you can even put a little bit of foil on top of it if you're concerned about the browning. So keep that in mind. These acorn squash are nice and juicy, and as you can see, I'm putting them into the bowl and just kind of playing around with it because it's the first time we've tried this. But the squash are nice and soft, and I even had a little juice down in the bottom of my parchment paper, and you'll definitely want to do that because that helps to keep your pan nice and clean. And everything's going to clean up very quickly. Then we're going to put the chops on the plate. And see that cleanup? Ah, see how quick that is? 1, 2, 3. Done. Skillet's clean. I'll take a towel and just wipe it out. Now, let's get to those chops. I just covered them for a few minutes so they'd have a chance to stay warm. We're going to put them into the
and onto the plate. And then once that's done, dinner is going to be served. So there's our squash and chops ready to go.
This week, fall starts officially. Now, I don't know about where you are, but our temperatures are starting to slowly but surely creep down. And that means it's time to get some warmer vegetables into our family. So let's see what we can do here. And let's cook a delicious fall meal. Second, we're going to put together some meatballs. So I've got about 1.5 pounds of ground beef, and actually it's ground round. I just call it ground beef because it is. That's what it is. And I have a sink full of water here so that I can keep my hands pretty clean while we're working. As you know, dealing with ground beef, and anytime you're dealing with raw meat, you need to be very careful. Now, the first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to add in some seasonings, and I'm going to put in some Italian seasonings first. I'm putting in a teaspoon. I'll look at that and see how that goes. I think I need a second. I'll say about 2 teaspoons of Italian seasonings. I'm going to also add in some granulated garlic. And I'm going to start, oh, you know what? Yeah, I'll put in 1 teaspoon of granulated garlic. Just a little more. And I have some fresh garlic that I'm also going to add in. So I'm going to add in about 1 heaping teaspoon of fresh garlic that I'll break up in there. It's going to get mixed up. Okay, we need some onion powder, and I thought I had onion powder right here. There it is. And we're going to add in a little onion powder. Oh, my top came off. I think we have more than enough already. So that little top came off, and it added some onion. So we're going to take it for what it's worth. Now I have some unseasoned panko crumbs that I'm going to add in, breadcrumbs, panko breadcrumbs, and I had about 1/2 a can, so I'm going to put that in as well, and we need an egg. Now, I put our egg in the center here, and I'm going to take my hand and just kind of break it up, and then we're going to start mixing. Now, we don't want to overmix, but we do want to make sure that all the seasoning gets distributed. And you know that little extra onion powder, we want to make sure that we get that to all parts of this mixture. So we're going to work on that. I don't want them to be tough. Going to put these together. I'm going to lay them on parchment, and then when I turn the oven on later today, I'll put these in so that they can go ahead and cook. But I'm going to get them ready. So what I'm going to do, I want a ball about that size. Container so that we don't have to dirty up anything else. Now this may actually be enough for 2 suppers. I'm thinking I could have meatballs and pasta sauce and a red sauce. I could also have meatballs.
This dish smells wonderful, and I have just enough for another meal of meatball subs. Going to continue making meatballs and sitting them here in the pan. I'm just taking a scoop, a hand scoop, pressing it together, making my meatballs, and then continue to do that until I have them all made, and then I'll bring you back. I am so glad that you spent time in the kitchen with me here at Ebony, Ivy, and Time, because you know our family loves to cook and to decorate and to chat right here in the kitchen. Now, you know, at Ebony, Ivy, and Time that we do things in the kitchen for the kitchen. And you know, it takes all of those things to make a home a warm and happy place, because our kitchen is the hub, the heart of the home. Now, the time that we spend in the kitchen should be loving, nurturing, encouraging, and guiding each other, our families, and our friends over delicious meals are just across the counter. Your kitchen should be the place where everyone wants to come, have a seat, and get a hug. You are invited always to join our family. And if you are new to this channel, then I hope you will subscribe before you leave. And I say thank you to my new subscribers, as well as thank you to those of you who have been on this journey for some time. Because together, we are building strong families, one meal at a time. Have a blessed and wonderful day.